Okay, Revolution has always got our back when it comes to home electronics, solar panels, water heaters, thermal water heaters. And I'm joined by Eric today. You know, I'm glad to be talking to you because you're going to show us something that I think a lot of homes in Hawaii are familiar with, these thermal solar water heaters, right?
Right. So, yeah, they say about 1 in 4 homes in Hawaii has a solar thermal system, and that goes all the way back to the 80s,
yes,
right?
In fact, I think ours is from the 80s at my house.
A lot of people's are. People's solar IQ, I'd say, in Hawaii is much higher than the rest of the nation because we've adopted solar for so long. Mm-hmm. In the 80s, there was a huge boom in solar, and so usually when you say you got solar, people say, yeah. And then you have to probe a little bit more to determine,
yeah, is it PV,
right,
thermal,
exactly,
and all these things. And to be honest, so we don't have PV, but we have the thermal kind. But to be honest, technology has changed since 1980,
quite
right?
Quite a bit.
What do we have in here today, this box?
I'm not quite sure. I really have an opener. I know it's probably cobwebs and all kinds of stuff, but this is where our solar thermal tank is located. And like a lot of homes in Hawaii, it's out of sight, out of mind, right? Mm-hmm. So let's take, you ready?
Yeah, okay. Let's see if there's anything that's going to jump out.
If anything
out
jumps out,
yeah,
you
okay,
get it.
You
right?
Protect me. Oh, I see some geckos and stuff and leaves. But yeah, it looks like it's been a while for this one.
Yeah, so this is fairly typical to what most people have in Hawaii.
So what are we seeing here? You break it down, like these pipes and everything like that. What is a typical system kind of built around?
So it's kind of Frankensteinish, right? Mm-hmm. You've got all of these pipes, almost like you really can't even see the tank,
yeah,
right?
That's true.
So I'm looking right here and I see about 11 valves.
Yeah.
Basically, all of this is necessary to take the cold water that's in the tank and pump it up to the roof to the collectors. It then gets warm and comes back down. But you've got a series of check valves and ball valves and this and that to ensure if anything happens, you can close it off and, you know, whatever, for maintenance, right? But most people don't know what to do with it, right?
Yeah.
When I look at this, all I see as a builder is points of failure.
Yeah, and the crazy thing is as we were talking, my son, about a couple years ago, the kids were playing in the garage where ours is. I didn't even know it was in the black closet there. We had just moved in the house. And all of a sudden, I hear him playing with all these things, which was like, oh, no, don't do that. But when you see stuff like this, these are also, like you were saying, points of possible leaks or problems in the future, right?
Correct.
So how do we minimize that, especially with the products that you guys have?
So we offer the sun ban, and I think we've talked about it in the shows in the past.
Yeah.
And it's also on display at our showroom. You know, it's the newest technology in heating water. Basically, picture a brand new tank with one conduit, an electrical conduit that comes down off the roof and into the tank, and that is connected to PV panels on your roof. It sends electricity down to a heating element, and that's it. So this, all of this pipe, the pump, the valves, all of that goes away.
Now, when someone wants, if they're at home, is it a complicated process to take this, as you said, Frankenstein unit out and put in one of your great ones?
No, it's very simple. I think many people may think PV, wait, is HECO involved?
Yeah.
That's not the case.
Interesting.
HECO's not involved in terms of the PV. Mm-hmm. So we come out, we do consultations every day. We take a look at your size of the tank that you have now, how many people are in the home,
and
we size it correctly. Uh-huh. It may be that you had a tank for 5 people, but 3 of them went off to college. And so now your tank is too large, right? And you're not using enough hot water.
Yeah,
and what that means, if you're not using your water, it's sitting there
it's degrading the inside of the tank.
Exactly.
I've heard that
before. So for people that love hot water and they love thermal, that's great. It's done a great job. What we're introducing is just a better, newer, you know, current time technology.
Well, what I love about Revolution is you guys have the industry experience and your know-how, the installation and what people need and stuff like that, and especially that great product. I think I'm going to talk to Grandpa and see if we can retire our Frankenstein unit. Now, if anybody wants to know, can they come down to the Innovation Center and actually see that as well and see it right in person?
All of our products are on display Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. We also hold our monthly seminar the third Saturday of every month. And they can visit us online.
I love it. Eric, thank you for showing us this. And I guess we can
close
this
door. All right.
I learned
maybe
a lot on that.
Maybe. All right.
It is. And like they said, they have one on display in their Innovation Center along with many other products. So if you want to go and just get more information, that's really the best,
the best way. And you can kind of play with all the buttons and see everything and how it actually fits. So that is very cool.